Now, you know, in the second chapter, actually, the whole Bhagavad Gita is summarized. First chapter has most of the questions of Arjuna. And second chapter, Krishna starts answering. He first takes a platform of teaching by jnana, that we are not the body, we are spirit. So, and then he talks about karma kanda, wherein different teachers basically how by first thing is by jnana means we are not body or spirit soul, so you are not killing anybody here. That is the platform. So look in the platform of knowledge. The second was karma kanda. Basically karma kanda means using scripture for our personal benefit. There is no objective of satisfying the law. So Krishna uses even that argument. So Arjuna, fight. If you die, you go to heaven. You go to heaven. You are in jail. If you win, you enjoy this world. Yeah, that's the duty of Kshatriya. So that's what generally we take. So Krishna even uses that. And the next Krishna goes to the platform of Krishna consciousness, of the yoga, to realize this platform of jnana. You know, when you do Krishna consciousness, automatically you understand the truth also, that you are not the body as well. So, and then Krishna opens different facets of Krishna consciousness. And then after that, Prabhupada says, the end of the chapter, in the summary, the beginning, some idea about devotion service to the Lord is given. And then at the end, Arjuna asks Krishna to tell about the behavior of a Sthitapragna. Sthitapragna is the person who is fully self-realized. And Krishna tells different teachers as the chapter closes. That's all happens in the second chapter. So the second chapter has one part is about jnana, karma kanda. Then about Buddhi Yoga, which is Krishna consciousness, and last about characteristic of Sthitapragna. These are the four parts of the second chapter. Now we come to third chapter. Third chapter is about Karma Yoga. So before we begin, we should know there are three things: karma, akarma, vikarma. That is where people make mistake. Now this I told you last time also. Basically, suppose karma means you are doing your duties, whatever role and responsibility you have. But in a varnashram society where everything is finally geared for the pleasure of the Lord, your duties go for the pleasure of the Lord. Otherwise, it is not so important. And vikarma means a sinful activity. Correct? Karma means according to varnashrama, wherever you are situated, brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, shudra, Brahmachari, Grahastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyasa. The chessboard with 16 blocks. Wherever you are situated, there are some duties to be performed. That is actually karma. Today we may have different kind of a system. We don't know what is, these things are difficult to define, but still understand the principle. Because the instructions are on the, all are on the background of varnashrama. And vikarma means not to do such activities, do sinful activities against an injunction of the scripture. That is called vikarma. That is not karma. Now somebody says, I work in a kasai khana, that is my karma. That is not karma, that is vikarma. Apna karam karo. Last time I gave you the joke, I told this also two times now. One more time. Because, you know, it has to be very important, it has to go inside. Takes time to digest. You know, we have to think deeply. Please think deeply again. Last Sunday also I told you. Suppose you are working for, you got a job in TCS. Okay. They gave you a car, they gave you a driver, a big office, AC, everything, book arrangement is there, computer is there, everything. And you come sit inside in the office. What you should do? Go and ask the boss, what is the work? Okay. He made all the arrangements. Instead of that, very nice. You open travel agency there only. And boss will come, what is this TCS, wow, what is this nonsense, correct? Like MRP, now you, they give all facilities and you open some office, their own business there. They'll come as a nonsense, so many work I have given you. So same way, Krishna has given us a body, such a wonderful body, we can't even imagine this body, such a wonderful body. We can't create. And you can't create one component of a self. Forget about creating a body of 100 trillion cells. No way. Nobody can do it. We can only talk. You can't do it. We can't match the intelligence even of Brahma. Forget about Krishna. This is Brahma's work. So now, So we got this body, we got all the facilities also to sustain this body. Nice air to breathe, the sun is there, all, you know, wonderful arrangement. And then we say, even if Krishna comes to tell you, what are you doing? You're supposed to do work for me. That's what he will tell in this chapter, towards the end. And he will tell Krishna, Aapi to bole dena Gita apna karam karo. Do your own work. Now this is actually a confusion which has destroyed the Vedic culture, because any nonsense person does, he puts it as if Krishna has taught such a thing. No way. Now let us try to understand the chapter of Karma Yoga. Now I go to the translation, where I need it, I go to the shlokas. Arjuna said, O Janardana, O Keshava, why do you engage in this ghastly warfare if you think that intelligence is better than fruitive work? Which is the shloka? Which shloka Krishna says that intelligence is better than fruitive work? Shloka 49. I'll go, I've done a bookmark, so I can immediately locate. You go here. Dure nahi avaran karma buddhi yoga dhananjaya buddho sharanam anvecha kripana phala hetava. What does it say? Meaning, dure, keep it far away. Avaram karma. Avaram karma means all abominable activities. You can see the translation. Keep it far away. Buddhi yoga. Use your intelligence to understand. Dhananjaya version. Link your intelligence to me and keep our abominable activities far away. And essence, what is happening, Arjuna is feeling that killing all these people in the battlefield is a fruitive activity. Activity for his own pleasure. And it is sinful. Because he is giving pain to so many people. So, Krishna, you only told, no. Keep all avaram karma. He is thinking killing these people is avaram karma. It's an abominable activity. Keep it far away. And what you should do? Buddhi yoga dhananjaya. Buddhi means intelligence. Yoga means linked to Lord. You link your intelligence to me. Understood. Very nice. Krishna says, no need to fight. He's trying to avoid. Just like studies are there. So we can tell parents, what is all these studies? Finally, we study to get some money. It is our own karma. I'll move, maybe my intelligence and fix on Krishna. Bhagavad Gita also teaches that. And then what happens? Next shloka also similarly he continues. And what does he say in the next shloka? It's a very similar line. Now here he says, Vimashineva Vakena. This means equivocal. Because Krishna said so many things in the second chapter. Just like you go to buy a sari or you go to buy a pant, and friend says to you, this brand is also good, this brand is also good. Or say car, you want to buy a car. Somebody said you can buy Toyota, somebody, then he said, hey, Honda is also good. I think you can buy Ford. What do you say? Ekam vada. Ek cheez bolo, bhaiya, teen kiske hote, confusion hota hai. Correct? You get confused, no, which one to buy? Then I ask you for your opinion, which one you should buy? Ah, you can buy a Honda. Ford is also good. I think Toyota is not bad. Arre, tell me one, why are you confusing me? It's the same way he's saying, Eka tad ekam. Please tell me one. What ekam bhada? Please tell me your one definite decision. Karma yoga karna hai, jnana yoga karna hai, kya karna hai? I'm getting confused. So he is saying, buddhim mohayasi. Mohayasi means moh jata na. We are deluded. So all my intelligence is getting confused. You told so many things in the second chapter. You told about jnana, you told about this, so many things. Karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, I am confused what I am supposed to do. Please tell properly. Krishna didn't want to confuse him, but you know, all the subject Arjuna wants Krishna to bring out now carefully, systematically, because it came off too fast. So he wants it to now elaborate each into a different chapter. There are two chapters now which will talk about karma yoga, the third chapter and fifth chapter. There are also discussion about jnana yoga, the fourth chapter. And the sixth chapter is about Ashtanga. Like that, you know, Krishna is going to speak about so many things. He's going to elaborate what he has told. In brief, he has already told. He's saying, I'm getting a little confused. It is looking equivocal. All instructions look to be contradictory. So Krishna understands. And now let us see what is Krishna's instruction. The blessed Lord said, O sinless Arjuna, I have already explained that there are two classes of men who realize the self. Some are inclined to understanding by empirical philosophical speculation, others are inclined to know by devotion. Some people sit and speculate about the Lord. Okay? That is one way people try to understand the Lord. And other people engage in devotion service. Okay? So there are two ways. On one sense, both are on the right path only. Next, not by really abstaining from one, one can achieve freedom from reaction, nor by renouncing in alone one can attain perfection. Now, unless I am pure, because Arjuna was saying, what is there? I have to kill all these people. I can just sit down somewhere and chant Hare Krishna. So Krishna is saying, this is also devotion service. Because, you see, many a time people have this confusion. This question of Arjuna is again repeated in the 5th chapter. That means it's a very important question. Why is Arjuna asking the same question 2 times? Most of the people feel spiritual life means there are no duties, there are no responsibilities, and I become a, you know, they say, you know, I all fix on destiny and I will just sleep in one corner. You know, many people have this idea. You know, and the Mayavadis means the first thing, if you go in personalist, first thing they tell you is to take sannyas. This is of Maya. Brahma Satya, Jagat Mithya. Take sannyas. And therefore people also in India, it is when somebody becomes serious in spiritual life, they think it's not practical. Therefore Arjuna is twice asking this question. And Krishna is. So Krishna is saying it. See, number one, it is not easy to sit down in one place and meditate. It's not easy. Or to chant the names of the Lord. Krishna is saying you can't do that in an immature situation. Therefore, you should at this moment do your activity. But the activity should be linked to the Supreme Lord. Otherwise the activity is not. Somehow that activity should have a link for the pleasure of the Lord. Otherwise it is not karma yoga, it is karma yoga. Some way they should have. You do the activity and enjoy the result, it is not karma yoga, it is karma yoga. There is karma yoga as well. Jnana yoga and jnana bhoga is also there. You cultivate knowledge independent of the Lord. That is jnana bhoga. I become so knowledgeable. But you cultivate knowledge, trying to understand the glories of the Lord, that is jnana, yoga. So yoga means a link, should be. Jnana, karma, anything not linked has to be thrown. So Krishna is saying, yeah, just by abstaining from work, like some people do in Barakat Sanyasa, they give up all activity, just sit down. Krishna is saying, heart is not going to get purified. In fact, sometimes what happened, some disciples of Prabhupada approached Prabhupada, please give us Babaji Sanyas. I told this many times before. And Prabhupada says, no, even my Guru Maharaj did not give anybody. Previously, in our Sampradaya, there are two Babajis, Jagannathas Babaji and Lord Vishwadas Babaji. Who is the Guru of Bhaktisiddhanta? Now, these two are Babajis. Babajis means they were just sitting in one place and chanting. They are not preaching. But Bhaktisiddhanta Prabhupada, after that, you know, that was the time they could do. But after that, as the age is progressing, and also this Babaji is in a, is as an exception. It is an exception, not a rule, even at that time. Somebody is dictated from the Lord within. They are devotees, sometimes they are dictated from the Lord within. You just sit down and chant. And just by chanting, he can purify the Holy Ghost. One. And number two, he has a purity of the mind to chant over and over. We can't artificially do that. Therefore, in his movement, Prabhupada said devotees do have a sadhana, but they should actively engage whole day in devotion service. Correct? He never gave this formula that you can just sit down and chant. You know, it looks very attractive. Sometimes we feel like that. Yes, sir, band karke chalo, we'll sit down in Vrindavan and we'll just chant again. Try. 2-3 days, all your desires will suffocate you. Therefore, at this situation, the package is be busily engaged through the day and morning and evening have a sadhana. Sometimes you feel that all the so many things we are doing, actually higher than this will be if I can just abandon all this thing and sit in Vrindavan or Mayapur and chant Hare Krishna. So this shloka even applies for a devotee, because this artificially renouncing without purification will only cause disturbance in society. There are some people, they take sannyas, that means sannyas means they leave their wife and run away, and then after that, because heart is not pure, they run away with some other woman. It has happened many times. So that is not correct. Correct? Better remain at home. Just like Bharat Maharaj. Now his situation is different, but that was not advisable what he did. You know, he left his wife at home and she was crying, and he went to the forest for self-realization. That was okay. But there he got attached to a deer, and he whole day playing with the deer. And instead of playing with the child at home, he wanted to do that only. And deer is not, because across the species, relationship are not so congenial. You can have, but it's not very congenial. So what the deer has to do with it? He has to play with she deer. He's running away. And he's running behind. It's not practical. And finally, it ended up mess. So therefore, true, Bharat Maharaj's situation is different for the highly advanced devotee. We should be careful. Now comes, all men are forced to act helplessly according to the impulses born of the modes of mental nature. Therefore, no one can refrain from doing something even for a moment. You cannot say, I will sit down. Krishna is giving the reason for it. Why you cannot sit down? Because soul, therefore Prabhupada says, we don't want sit down philosophy. We want active philosophy. Krishna did not allow Arjuna to sit down. It's a fight. Prabhupada many times says, the two wars in the history, with the two big wars in the history, Mahabharata and Ramayana, actually the modern day world wars are nothing important. If you count the number of soldiers also died, you can't even count. Huge, 18 Akshaunis, Mahabharata eliminated. 11 on the side of the Kauravas, 7 on the side of the Pandavas. 18 day, one day one Akshauni was eliminated. And Akshauni, if you count, is like millions of soldiers. Huge. There are, you know, lakhs of chariots and correct? It's a huge, it's a battalion, you know, it's like a regiment, division. In army nowadays we have a division, 18 divisions of army were finished. So it's a huge war. So now Arjuna is saying, you know, in both the wars, point was, devotee was a hero. In this war, Mahabharata, Arjuna was a hero. And in Ramayana, Hanuman was a hero. Both are Vaishnavas. So who says Vaishnavas don't work? Vaishnavas don't work. Correct? Similarly, Krishna doesn't want Arjuna. You get into wrong philosophy, then you can just sit down. Sit down has to work. So there is no sit down philosophy. Our is practical working philosophy. Very practical philosophy. So Krishna is saying, Arjuna, try to understand this. You want to sit down, but everybody is forced to work because of the modes of material nature is situated. Arjuna is a Kshatriya. If he refrains from fighting there, he will fight in the forest. Because something he will see injustice and he will start fighting. He can't do anything else. So better fight for a good cause. Some injustice happen in the forest also. There also he fight. Better let him do something, big work where the Lord wants him to do. He is saying, you can't act, you can't become inactive. Everybody is forced to act according to the impulses born of the modes of nature. Whatever modes of nature, suppose somebody is, see, it's like this. If I am having some infection, you put on the fan, I start sneezing. I have no control over myself. That means, this is may not be my natural behavior. My natural behavior may be the samadhi on Krishna. True? But today what is happening, the infection is forcing some behavior out of me. My sneezing is not my healthy behavior. It is imposed because of the infection I am having. So Krishna is saying, everybody is forced to act because of the infection. True. Dovetail it today for my infection. In either way. In higher way, it's Krishna's order. Pure devotee should act for his order anyway. Now even as a Kshatriya, Kshatriya means you will fight. Use it for my infection. So he is in that way. See. Therefore, you can't refrain even for a moment. What is this you are telling? I will not fight. Artificial. Inactivity is also an activity. Another deep meaning. Inactivity is also an activity. Like Bhishma and Drona were silent when there was an attempt to disrobe Draupadi. That is the reason they died. It's a simple activity to remain silent. True or not? You have the powers to stop something. They could have stopped or not. Anybody can fight with Drona? No. Nobody, no follower could ever fight with Dronacharya. Anybody could have fought with Bhishma? Never. He was much greater than Dronacharya. If he had just said no, even Dhritarashtra had no courage. Nobody can say anything. Some reason, that's a different reason. Both kept silent. It's a sinful activity. So inactivity is not, you know, sometimes it happens. somebody in the road, an accident happened, recently it happened here only. Somebody died just in front of our place. Some of the boys saw also. So you say, I will not do anything, a simple act. Nowadays you say, no, I will not take to hospital, I don't take to hospital, simple activity. So you have to be careful actually. True, law situation is such that people, laws are so dirty. You take and then every day you have to go to court. Therefore people all hesitate. But recently they made a law that no questions will be asked. They made a law, but it is still dangerous. The dying patient is very dangerous. No, but I'm just telling, see, Krishna is speaking in an ideal setting. This word is crazy. But at least know the principles and understand where you can apply them. But principle is correct. If you can stop something which is bad and you don't do it, you sit silent. It's a sinful activity. Okay? So inactivity is also an activity. It is vikarma. One who restrains the senses of organ and action, but his mind dwells in sense objects, certainly deludes himself and is called a pretender. So Arjuna, you think you'll go sit in the forest? That you can't do. You are a kshatriya. You are forced to act. Just like a man having cold infection anywhere else. So there also you are passionate mode, because Krishna is teaching to Arjuna. Arjuna is a liberated person who is teaching on the platform of a kshatriya. He has taken a role of ordinary kshatriya here. Krishna is instructing him. So he is saying here, so he is continuing on that. So you act like a sannyasi because you say, I will give up kingdom, everything, I live by begging. That is activity of sannyasi. Kshatriya cannot beg. Sannyasi can only beg. So I will sit down there and I beg. Because sannyasi, why he can beg? He is constantly engaged in Krishna Samadhi. So he has no time. He can go, and people knowing his elevated condition, he used to give him some lakshya. No problem. And that is the Vedic system. But you got kshatriya. You cannot imitate his condition. And then Krishna is saying, you externally become a sannyasi, okay, by dress or everything, but mind is running for sense objects, you are a hypocrite. That is called a very strong word, mithya achara. Mithya means wrong, no? Mithya achara means behavior, false behavior. That is hypocrite, which is very insulting for Arjuna. That will be very, it's called a pretender. So don't pretend to be a sannyasi. You are dharma is a kshatriya. Act on that platform. Don't artificially take the position of a sannyasi. What is the need to fight Krishna? That's what he wrote. What is the need to fight? I can sit and chant Hare Krishna. Don't artificially take position of a sannyasi. Purify yourself. You are on the platform now of a kshatriya. Work. On the other hand, you control the senses and mind and engage the active organs in work or devotion without attachment is not possible. So whatever the situation, you are a kshatriya. Arjuna knew the art of killing. One thing Arjuna knows how to kill is use it for Krishna's mission. Yadayarahi dharmasa gani. Krishna has come for that. So Krishna is telling him, kill on my behalf. And he wants Arjuna to get all the glory. And Arjuna just do it. So when he is using his even killing or whatever ability you have, I am a doctor, I am an engineer, whatever you are. That activity, you do it for the Lord's pleasure, some way or other. Then, that is by far superior than a hypocrite. What's on the purpose of that? You know, there are some temples where what happens, it is called joint mess. Prabhupada called it joint mess. Joint mess means there is no preaching activity. All the brahmacharis go whole day, collect dakshina. Or if some by mistake somebody comes into the temple, loot him. Don't leave him. And after that, all the money you buy, commodities, go to the kitchen. And it is, that is called joint mess. That is not called temple. You know, temple is different, joint mess is different. It's only in the name temple. Great all commodities, let us cook, nicely eat and then sleep. There is not this much desire to give message of Krishna to anybody. Correct? That is called joint mess. Bhaksana Prabhupada said, better than having joint mess, have a broom and sweep on the road and earn an honest livelihood. Correct? This is actually a glorious statement, beautiful statement. So here is a similar to what Krishna is telling. You control your senses and mind by what? Engagement. You can't disengage. So you are a kshatriya, engage yourself like a kshatriya. Or for even just like now you may say, what is our situation?
because it takes shelter of Acharya, your prescribed duties become order of the Acharya. When somebody takes shelter of Prabhupada, then his prescribed duties become different. His prescribed duties is order of the Acharya. You engage whole day in the activities for the Prabhupada's pleasure. Otherwise, wherever you are situated, in Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, use your do your prescribed duties. He absorbed in that, and the result is offered to Krishna. That is by far superior than artificially taking the role of what is called Markata Sannyasa, that is impersonalism. Vaishnavas don't. In fact, in Kali Yuga, Sannyasa is banned. There are five things which are banned in Kali Yuga. One of the things is Sannyasa. And the Sannyasa that refers to is Markata Sannyasa. Markata Sannyasa means they'll go sit down, they'll not do anything. Mind go, will go, freeze come. Like stone, they make the mind, no desire. You've seen that they do mona and they sit down for days all together. That is banned for Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga, everybody is so much agitated. If he is not idle mind, devil's workshop. Nothing else will happen. No, I am thinking about Krishna. You know what we are thinking. That is the condition. So we have to be busy. Even in the moment Prabhupada made the devotees work hard. Very interesting thing used to happen. Prabhupada's guru, he also was the same Vatsana Prabhupada. He used to travel to his 64, he had 64 Gaudiya Mathas and maybe around 10,000 disciples. Huge mission. And when he used to travel and see any Matha, he used to sometimes see what is happening. And once he went, and there were Ekadashi, and all were doing Nirjala, and they were sleeping. And so he woke up. What is happening? Why you guys? No, Gurudev, Ekadashi, Nirjala. He says, please eat something, and all of you get out, do some preaching. Because this is not a platform in Kali Yuga. And then even Prabhupada, what he used to do after that, is to go outside, in the temple, in the Matha name, take a huge loan, and go away from the place. Because he can sign a loan, he is the head of the whole organization. Then they have to run every day to bring money to recover the loan. So somehow keep them busy. That is how the art of management. People should be busy, engaged. Even as parents, our main thing should be today. The parents don't know that. Children are free good. No. Keep them busy in good work. Then they grow so nicely. Correct? Otherwise, engage in active service and work of devotion without attachment is by far superior. Okay? It's very nicely understood. A sweeper in the street is more glorious than a man who artificially takes sannyasa but the whole day thinking about sensitive. I remember in Kumbhela, this was little less strong, but it's a fact. This 2001, the last Kumbhela, not this one. And one police officer, he became very friendly to us. He told me one day that when he was inspecting, in the morning time when he go, he saw a so-called sannyasi, there are thousands of so-called sannyasi, some are genuine, some are bogus. Engage the woman, in some corner in a river. He became so upset, he blasted. He said, "Kya ho raha hai? What are you doing here? This is not a public place. What is going on in the open way? Like dogs in the street. I'm on a sannyasi. Why you should anyway do? You're a sannyasi." So he became very ashamed and he said, "Vairagya nahi hai." He, that fellow sannyasi. He said, "Vairagya nahi hai, toh hamara dress pehno. Aur kaam karo." Perfect or not? Same thing this shloka has said. Instead of being a hypocrite sannyasi, honestly work on your life. Is it? Otherwise, you're a parasite on the society for nothing. On the other hand, you control the senses by the mind, engages active organs in work of devotion. Whatever work he is doing, but don't use that work just for your pleasure. Okay? You think whatever reserve comes, it belongs to Krishna. Something I can take for my maintenance. Simple living? I think. Not high living, I think. Simple living? I think. That is best. Without attachment in my part. Perform your prescribed duty, for action is better than inaction. A man cannot even maintain his physical body without work. This time parents also tell us so many times this instruction. Arre beta padhoge nahi to khaoge kaise kal? Krishna is also telling us, Supreme Father. Arre do your prescribed duty. Action is better than inaction. Arre he is on that platform as a Kshatriya. If you don't work as a Kshatriya, how are you going to maintain yourself? You can't beg. Kshatriya can't beg. Only in the Vedic culture, exception was given to sannyasis. But they should be genuine. They were maintained by the society. Happy. Just like children are maintained happily, sannyasis are maintained in the society. Otherwise, everybody was supposed to work for his livelihood. So how could you eat? Beg, you can't beg. Kshatriya is not allowed to beg. Only sannyasi can beg. So Krishna is saying, man cannot even maintain his physical body. So how will you maintain yourself? Now Krishna has given a one platform. Now he is again lifting it more. This shloka, I think you should all remember. It's a beautiful shloka. यज्ञार्थात् कर्मणो अन्यत्र लोकोऽयं कर्मबन्धनः तदर्थं कर्म कौन्तेया मुक्तसङ्गा समाचरा यज्ञार्थात् कर्म ऑल द एक्टिविटीज शुड बी डन फॉर यज्ञ पुरुष इज सुप्रीम लॉर्ड विष्णु ऑल एक्टिविटीज शुड बी डन फॉर द प्लेजर ऑफ विष्णु Otherwise, anyatra means other, will lead to karma bandhanaha. If you do activity for your pleasure, you get entangled. You get trapped with the reaction. See, like example, when you go for India and you fight with Pakistan, so we don't wish fight occurs, but dharma yuddha is nothing wrong. Mischief has been done, punish. Don't be a coward. Now, suppose if war happens and you fight, kill so many people. Okay? Will any punishment come? So similar way, when you act for Krishna, you are not entangled. Just like food. When you are cooking food, even vegetarian food is in. All of us know that? So therefore, because why you have killed the plant? No. Some people ask this question. So here is the answer. Yajnartha offered the food to Krishna. Therefore, Prabhupada said, we are not vegetarian. We are Krishnatarian. Prashadatarian or Krishnatarian? So offer the food to Krishna, that is beautiful. Without offering, don't eat. Okay? So any activity, it should be connected to Krishna. Otherwise, be ready to take the reaction. When you are walking also, you are killing insects. When you are breathing also, you are killing. So you should breathe for Krishna, walk for Krishna, eat for Krishna, sleep for Krishna. Everything. If you forget Krishna, be simple activity. It's very deep. Nobody can say, I will not do simple activity. Anybody say? I will not do simple. You can't do that. You walk, you drive your bike on the road, so many ants will die. Take the reaction now. Reaction is next life you have to be killed like that. Are you ready for that? No. You have to drive for Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. How do I serve you? Keep thinking. Drive for Krishna means your consciousness is always for Krishna's pleasure. And automatically the activities were also for Krishna. Then you are protected. Otherwise, Krishna can take any amount of karma. In the beginning of creation, Lord of all creatures sent forth generations of men and demigods along with the sacrifice for Vishnu and blessed them by saying, be thou happy in this yajna because the performance is bestowed upon all desirable things. Now what happens is devatas and humanity, they are linked together. Devatas, their food is a prasadam that they get in a yajna. You know, therefore Indra was very upset when yajna was stopped for him. Any yajna, even deva yajna. If it is people, many times people do yajna for devatas, but they forget the yajna purusha is Vishnu. All the devatas are nothing but angas of Vishnu. Correct? So yajna purusha has to be Vishnu. For him you worship, prasadam you offer to the devatas. That is the proper devata puja. But many people directly worship devatas. But actually that is not the best way to do. Highest will be you worship Vishnu, give prasadam to the devata. They are his servants. They will be very happy to take prasadam. Their food is that prasadam. Not directly. They have to get prasada from yajnas. Therefore, when the devatas don't get the prasada, they get upset. That like Indra, when they say Govardhan puja, you stop. No, Indra puja, you stop, correct? And worship Govardhan. And Indra got upset, therefore the Govardhan leela happened, Krishna lifted the mountain. So Krishna has made an interrelation. In the next shloka, it becomes the interrelation. The demigod being pleased by sacrifice will also please you. The nourishing one another, they will rain general prosperity for all. So, you know, everything is an interrelation in this world. We do, but sometimes people say that nobody is properly doing Devata Puja. Just like Ganesha, the festival comes, what they do? Some film songs they put. And all the moms, loud they put. You think Ganesha is happy? He's not happy. So why reaction has not come? It will come. Because, you know, this is all higher devatas, all time scale is much different. In just few days, yajnas have stopped. So they will act it. Then you will see, no food, no water. Kaliyuga is predicted, no? There will be no food, no grains, no milk. All will happen. They will see, just like you use electricity, you have to pay tax. You can't take it free. You take sunlight, you have to pay tax. So all the devatas therefore have to be appeased. And how they are appeased? You offer, you know, to Vishnu and give the prasad. In Kaliyuga, all these details are very difficult to do. Therefore, the scriptures say, just by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, all our dharma is completed. Therefore, see what you do. We don't do any devata yagna. We just chant Hare Krishna. Yagnai sankirtana praya. If you do the sankirtana yagna, just like in a tree, if you put water in the root, it goes to all the leaves. Just like you pay tax now, a tax tiger. True, but you put tax and then it is rooted away, but I am saying the system. You pay tax. It is said in the Bhagavatam that in Kaliyuga, the thieves take over the government and then organize and loot the public. Previously, thieves used to go to house and steal 100 rupees, 500 rupees. Now they take over the government and then they organize and loot. It is already predicted in Bhagavatam. Anyway, but I am just telling the system. You give to the income tax department and the money is distributed to road department, this department, that department, that department. You don't have to separately go. And I will give some money to military, some money to road, some money to water. Okay? Automatically distributed. So similarly, you worship Vishnu or you put food in the stomach, automatically distributed. You can't take a syringe and put little hair, no need. Just put it in the mouth, through the mouth. Don't put food through the ear. This is called Devata Puja. Through the mouth. Sometimes when somebody says through the mouth, so many things they do, but it is best through the mouth. In charge of the various necessities, the demigod being satisfied to perform the yagna, supply all necessities to man. But he who enjoys this gift without offering to the demigod in return is certainly a thief. Because devatas have been delegated the power to make all arrangements. Just like you take electricity and you don't pay a bill, you're a thief. So you should show gratitude to the devata in the form of giving them some yagna prasada. But again in Kaliyuga, just to Harinam Sankirtan, they are satisfied. This is a famous shloka. Yagna shishta sina santo munchyate sarva kil vishaye munchyate te tu agam papa ye pachanti atma karana. Very important shloka. Whatever is offered in yagna, yagna shishta, shishta means food after. Now when you offer to the Lord, it is a food, therefore prasadam is very tasty. It is tasted by the Lord. Lord's saliva is there. Mystically, the Krishna is so great. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam. Even though he expands to so many forms, Krishna remains as it is. So Krishna eats food, but he remains as it is. Because that becomes also Purna. How? You can't understand. That is Krishna's purpose. Krishna is inconceivable. But Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Patram Pushyam Phalam Toyam. Yoga Bhakta? Prachati. The Prabhupada says, Krishna is lying or what? Krishna is telling a lie. You offer to me and I'll eat. He is not telling a lie. He eats. Avoided with bhakti we offer. So all your kilvishai, all your, you know, sins will be washed away if you eat prasada. So very important to eat prasada. Offer to the Lord and eat. Don't eat directly. Why? Bhujite tetu akam papam ye prachati atma karana. Those who are eating food, you know, aray, today I want to have samosa, cook and eat. Yes, take all the sin also. Take the sin also. Because whatever sin is involved in making samosa, you have killed so many living entities while cooking also. All the sin you have to eat, globulates of sin. So why can't you just give 5 minutes it takes to offer? What is the difficulty? You cook very nicely, but you can't cheat. Many people, what they do, what they want to eat, they cook. And just like you get a stamp, no? Like from a government office. In Krishna, keep in front of Krishna, stamp and then prasadam I am eating. No. From the moment you purchase a grocery, from that moment you have to think, for Lord's pleasure, I want to make samosa. Sincerity has to count. You can't cheat Krishna. You can cheat anybody. That is called real prasadam. You buy the items, yes. We are not offered to Krishna, Radha Govinda, some samosa long time. Let us try to do that. You buy the grocery. And then you bring it. And then you cook. And then you offer. भुजते देतु अगम पापम ये पचन्ति आत्म कारणा. सो दो पीपल हु डू नॉट ऑफर टू द लॉर्ड ए नीड, दे आर ओनली ईटिंग गॉबलेट्स ऑफ सिन. दैट्स अ प्रॉपर ट्रांसलेशन. This is, you know, sometimes Prabhupada said, he was in a class and he was telling Bhagavad Gita is a solution to all the problems, social problem, political problem, you know, religious problem, all economic problem also. So one person in the audience, he was a new person, raised hand. Swamiji, tell me this first, how can Gita solve economic problem? Everybody is talking economic problem, economy is not growing only, some 4%, 5%. They said in the last decade, the so low IIP industrial production was never so low, like that. So here economic problem is solved in Gita. Annad bhavati bhutani,
annad bhavati bhutani,
annad bhavanti bhutani,
annad bhavanti bhutani,
parjanyat anna sambhavah,
parjanyat anna sambhavah,
yagnat bhavati parjanyo,
yagnat bhavati parjanyo,
yagnat karma samudbhavah,
yagnat karma samudbhavah.
Now, is it that, you know, common sense? When if some of your friends are there, they say, yeah, Gita is not practical. It's not scientific. What is this here? Anna bhavanti bhutani. All living entities subsist on food grain. Isn't it true? Isn't it true? So logical it is. Every living entity needs anna. Parjanyat anna sambhava. And how do grain come from rain? Is it difficult to understand? We all need food to eat and food comes because of rain. You know, even at IQ 10 can understand. Yagna bhavati parjanya, but that you can understand. This rain is coming because of yagna. When every year, the meteorological department, normal rain, normal monsoon. That will they will announce every year. And after that, actually, they themselves don't know, even though they have big supercomputers they have put in to understand how this monsoon are, you know, moving. Something that they say sometimes, El Nino, this Nino, so many factors are there, exactly they can't tell. That's a fact actually. Even though they are trying, even the best of the countries are trying, they can't exactly predict. Then how much rain will it be? Sometimes they say, no, we will send some helicopters or aircraft and we will put some seed. You know what is that? That is like a... That kind of... How much water you get? Just like on, you know, you take some with a hand, on head you put water. That kind of rain it produces. What is the use of that rain? You know, one kind of, you know, little. Just like after puja, they throw some water in it. They cannot do with their aircrafts anything more than that. So, this is the big doubt. How it comes? So Krishna is saying it is mystic. It looks automatic. That is how Krishna's creation is. There are so many factors. One moving another. Forget Krishna. They can't even see hand of Devatas. Krishna's hand is even behind the Devatas because he's ordering Devatas to do work for him. Just like if I take a remote and switch it off. If you do not know there is something called remote, you don't understand what I did. You will think maybe some, you know, short circuit happened at system. You will not be able to understand my invisible hand. True. Some people have some remote and they can do something. If you do not know, you get surprised. Even there is a remote to switch off the laptop also. But if you don't know, you think something happened and it's just true. So like that, Krishna's hand is not so. Yagna bhavati parjanyo. This is difficult to understand, but it's a fact. First two are correct, third is also correct. When a yagna is done, devata is satisfied. Yeah, this is rain is in the hand of Indra. Department head is Indra. Placement department is Yamaraj. And rain, water department is Indra. Just like we have water department in Mangalore Corporation. And colleges, we have placement department. Yamaraj is the placement department. He decides where to send you after this body. Yagna bhavati parjanyo. Because of yagna, you get rain. And then yagna karma samudbhava. And yagna karma, how does a yagna? Is your prescribed duties. Whatever prescribed duties are there, which are connected to the Lord, that is yagna. But Prabhupada says, basically in SS, please in Kaliyuga do nama sankirtana. You don't need to have mridanga also. You don't need to even clap. Just sit down and peacefully chant. If you can clap, add good. You can add karta, still better. You can add mridanga, still better. But even if all these things are not there, just chant together. Every family should do it actually. Otherwise, what do we do? Whole family sits around the TV. Instead of that, sit around
the Lord, at least one picture of the Lord, if not the deities, and just for some moments, family that prays together stays together. You will see the family will stay together if you are doing Namas and Kirtanam. Otherwise, family only enjoys together food, TV, enjoy Lord. Then you know what happens? If you are worshipping the Lord together, after this body, you go to Vaikuntha together. For there is no need to split this family for Krishna. In spiritual world also continue. You can continue your service to the Lord and again you are together. You remember, well, that house used to be into Kirtana. You can remember and be happy. Regulated activity, the prescribed in the Veda that directly manifests the Supreme Personality of God. Consequently, the pervading transcendent is eternally situated in the acts of sacrifice. So Vedas prescribe regulated activities. We have activities, but Vedas regulate. No vikarma, karma. Okay. And this all is given by the scriptures. That's the point. So we can't act whimsically. See, but the Vedic direction is so made, one can satisfy one perverted desire and return to God. How? They regulate your activity. You know, you want to eat? Offer. You want to dance? Dance in front of Krishna. You want to sing? Sing for Krishna. So all activities are dovetails for Lord Krishna. That is the regulation. My dear Arjuna, man who does not follow this prescribed Vedic system of sacrifice certainly leads a life of sin, or a person delighting only senses lives in vain. This is what is happening today. Person just thinks, therefore the Vedic culture was what? So what does the shloka say? It says, I am indebted to the devatas, I am indebted to the rishis. Why I am indebted to the devatas? They give me rain, they give me air, they give me sunlight, all this devatas, sun god, rain god, whatever, Indra is out there. And then, rishis, they gave me knowledge by which I could regulate my activities. I am indebted to them. They gave me so much spiritual knowledge. And Devarshi, Bhuta, other living entities, they are also, cows are giving me milk. Other animals also give so much service. Apta, friends, they also help me. Devarshi, Bhuta, Apta, Nidam, other living entities, other human beings. So I am indebted to all of them, my own. My own forefathers, I am indebted to all of them. So my life is to clear the debt. But one thing is, if you serve Krishna, all is automatically clear. You don't have to one by one clear all the debt. Sarvatma yaha sharanam sharanya. If you particularly take shelter of Krishna, who is capable of taking shelter? Sharanyam. He is qualified to give shelter. He is qualified to be an object of shelter, fit to give shelter, fit to take shelter. There's so many ways you can say. There were two words of sharanam, sharanyam. If you do that, automatically all the debt are automatically cleared. If finally all they are agents of the Lord, they will, you put water in the root of the tree, it goes away. They all will be satisfied. Otherwise, person should always know he is indebted. That is beautiful life. Today people just live for sense pleasures. They don't know where is the time for sense pleasure. I'm indebted. Suppose you have a loan. Can you enjoy? You have a loan, you feel even embarrassed to buy something. Or you have to repay. Okay? Sometimes it happens. You're constantly addressed here. And you feel ashamed, you're in front of buying something. You have to pay back instead of you buy a new shirt. You should have better repaid my loan first. True? The same essence here, I am indebted. Where is the question of enjoying? First, let me clear that loan. So, like that. And then Prabhupada says, we can never repay the spiritual master. That's on a spiritual level. Okay? So, person who delighting in sense of only lives in one who is, however, taking pleasure in the self, who is illuminated in the self, who rejoices in the self, satisfied in the self only, fully satisfied when there is no duty. Now suppose, now this is a clause coming, suppose somebody is fully self-realized. For him there is no duty. Arjuna said, I will go to the forest and sit down and chant Hare Krishna. Krishna says, you are a Kshatriya. This is a different platform. He can do that. But you do that, what will happen?
you'll become a hypocrite. You will sit down as a sannyasi, and kshatriya means he wants many wives. Kshatriya means he has to fight. You see something, how to fight. How can you artificially take role of sannyasa when you are full of passion? Correct? Kshatriya behavior is different. So he is saying you will only be a hypocrite. But otherwise, Krishna is also telling there is a platform, Arjuna, where you can just sit down. But that is called Paramahamsa platform. Even devotees, we don't imitate that. Taking pleasure in the service, fully in love of Krishna, for him there is no duty. He acts, that is his good choice if he wants to act. But otherwise, there is nothing expected for him. He can be fully absorbed in Krishna. Rejoices and satisfied in the self only, fully satisfied in him, there is no duty for him. Okay? This is understood. Prabhupada says in the first word, it's more practically referring to a pure devotee, is constantly engaged in activities of Krishna consciousness. There, the shloka was, you know, sarvatmaya sharanam sharanya gato mukdatam parityakartam. Somebody is always absorbed in pleasure of Krishna. He doesn't have any material duties or responsibilities. You know, just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, or you know, he took sannyas, he left his wife and mother. So somebody may say it is simple activity. Fully he left forward. Pleasure of the Lord. That is. And an exception. A self-realized man has no purpose to fulfill in discharge of his prescribed duty, nor has he any reason to perform such work, nor is there any need to depend on any other living entity. Okay? He doesn't need to depend on any other living entity. Self-realized person has no purpose to fulfill. He just acts for the pleasure of the Lord. He has no personal motivation to do any activity. Therefore, without being attached to the fruits of activities, one should act as a matter of duty, for working without attachment, one attains the Supreme. Even kings like Janaka and others attained the perfection stage of performance of the prescribed duty. Therefore, just for the sake of educating the people in general, we should perform your work. Now, Krishna is giving an example. Who is Janaka? Whose father he was? So, Krishna is taking his name, not honoring, and he is a great personality. So he said they were fully self-realized people, but still they were dutifully just doing a rule in this world, giving a good example. Now this is very important. I tell students also, I went into society in Bangalore today morning and discussing. There are 6 lakh people in Bangalore. One person of the society, 6,000 people is one person. If you can make them 16 not chanting, you all can take the initiative. They become beautiful example for the society. Whole society will change. Just like suppose you are working as a doctor, you give them example, how can you be a nice devotee and also a doctor? Society is looking for examples. Society is not looking for preaching. Kali Yuga, nobody wants to. Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave an example of a great devotee. Because people in Kali Yuga particularly don't like upadesha. Do like this. Nobody likes this. Correct? But if you give a good example, they get impressed. Correct? You are a nice Krishna conscious person, but you are very good in a profession also. People get impressed. This is how I will act. So we have to give a good example wherever we are. Okay? Therefore, for the sake of educating people in general, we should act. And then the next shloka is very famous shloka. Yad yad acharati sheshna tatade vitaro jana sayat pramanam gurude lokasad anuvartate. What is the meaning? Yad acharati sheshna, whatever the leaders do, common man follows, and whatever standards are set, people accept that. So that should be Arjuna. If he runs away from the battlefield, Arjuna is a respected warrior, correct? He is giving a precedence, an example which is bad. And now, tomorrow, anybody in any profession, some difficulty is there, run away. Correct? We are in hospital, some patients are there, are very tough, run away. Because Arjuna did it. So it becomes an example. So Krishna is warning him, Arjuna, be careful what you are about to do. Whatever action a great man performs, common man follow in it. Whatever standard set by exemplary acts, all the world pursues. So Krishna already gave an example of Janaka. Now Krishna will give his own example. You know, you say you are smoking all the time, but don't smoke, and you are smoking. It doesn't make a sense. So
So Krishna is saying whether he is falling. He says, yes. O Sanaprita, there is no work prescribed for me within all the three planetary systems. Natasya karyam karanam cha vidyate. Krishna has more duties to perform. Why he doesn't? Are Baba, you do something because you want something. Krishna doesn't want, nor I even want of anything. There is nothing Krishna desires from this world. Why he wants anything from the dead material world? He doesn't want anything from this world. Still he is working. Krishna used to get up 3 o'clock in the morning every day, 3 hours before sunrise. And he used to sit down for this, you know, for whom he worship. He used to worship himself, but don't imitate. There is nothing higher than him. We have to worship him. But principle, we should get down for spiritual activity. Why he has to get up here? Why Lord, what sadhana Lord has to do? Just giving an example. Narada, when he came to Krishna's palace, Krishna washed his feet, giving an example. When Sudama came, Krishna again washed his feet, correct? Giving an example. So Krishna is acting, giving a good example. So we should therefore, Krishna is saying, see, I have no need to do, I also do, Baba. Why don't you do that? For if I did not engage in work of Partha, certainly all men would follow my path. Definitely whole world will follow the path of Krishna. He is the supreme leader, supreme personality. And then what will happen? If I should cease to work, then all the worlds will be put into ruination. I will cause of creating unwanted population, and I would thereby destroy the peace of all sentient beings. So Arjuna said, if I fight, Varna Shankara population will come. Krishna is turned his argument. If you don't fight, Varna Shankara will come. Now here Jayate, Varna Shankara. Here again Varna Shankara. Now see the word. Shankarasya, same Varna Shankara, Shankarasya. Of unwanted population. Again unwanted population. So Krishna has turned his argument. Varna Shankara. As the ignorant perform their duties with attachment to reserve, similarly the learned may also act, but without attachment, for the sake of leading the people on the right path. Now Prabhupada says, you know, the work of Krishna consciousness, ordinary work, suppose you are a devotee, you are also working in office, and a non-devotee is working. There is a wide gulf in consciousness. They look similar externally. Internally it is not same. It looks similar. That like we are cooking, other person is also cooking. Why don't we allow a non-devotee to enter the kitchen and cook? No. There is a great deal of difference. So many professional cooks are there, they can make so many nice activities. We don't invite them. Except on emergency like a festival. That also we don't offer to the deities, we offer to picture. We can't take it to the deities, even though best professional cook it up. We can't take it. So why? There is a wide gulf in consciousness. So that's what he is telling here, there is difference. So you do act. But you act without attachment to reserve. Nishkama, that is called Nishkama, Karma Phala Tyaga. The learned may also act without attachment for sake of leading the people on the right path. So instead of just instructing, this lady can't take that role. The people who are outside of the society can take that role. You give a good example to people. And people will, they are working with attachment. You work without attachment. And give them a good example. They will be inspired to take it. Let the wise not disturb the minds of ignorance who are attached to put in action. They should not be encouraged to refrain from work, but to engage in the work in the spirit of devotion. Now what happens, you know, in Bhagavad Gita, you know, there are 4 or 5 different standards. Say, there's the highest is the person who is in Samadhi on the law. Next is the person who is a sadhaka. Next is the person, you know, who is doing sadhana means just like we are all daily doing some sadhana, chanting the names of the Lord and trying to do some service. And then next is the standard who cannot do sadhana, but at least he feels pleasure in coming to the temple. Next is the platform of person who doesn't even do devotion service but do some punya work. So whatever platform somebody is situated, don't disturb. Don't disturb. Give a good example, let him gradually come out. Correct? Don't refrain, make him refrain from the work. Just like, you know, we know Vishnu worship is highest, Devata worship is lower. We all know that. That's what scriptures say. Bhagavad Gita also said that. Does it mean we go stand outside Devi temple and say, don't enter, don't enter? Do we do that? Let him do at his platform, that's fine. Krishna has invested in faith in the Devata worship. It's not on the same platform. Don't think like some people say, yatoma tatoma. No, that is not correct. Nursery, first class, second class, third class, 10th class, 12th class. Now you are studying in 9th class. But somebody is going to first class. You don't say, don't go, don't go. Let him go. He's fit for only first class. Let him go. It doesn't mean first class is wrong. So So we should not insult the Devadas, and we should not insult the Vedic, because the Veda has given that puja also. Veda has only given puja for Devadas also. Correct? Bhuta also. Let them do what can be done. Not that now Bhuta puja is going to go there. Stop all this. No need. Come to temple. He is on that platform. But don't think it is same. That is for Tamasic platform. This is Sattvic platform. What is the operation? We're just chanting Hare Krishna, we are so happy. And there in the dead of night, one Murga, we have to bite. And then at 2 o'clock in the night, we have to watch all that. Everybody is drunk, including the pujari. That's what I heard. This is another prema shloka. Prakate kriya manani gunai karmani sarvashah ahankara vimunatma kartaham iti manyate. See, we are always our activities. We are not actually experiencing our original consciousness. None of us. We are not experiencing, we have never experienced. Our original, you know that? It's a bewildering thing. How many of us are experiencing consciousness now? None. Neither we have ever experienced our original consciousness. Our original consciousness, I may be Gopa for Krishna. I don't even know that ecstasy. In spiritual world, they can't walk, they keep dancing all the time. Just like sometimes children, they become very happy, they can't walk only, they keep dancing. They feel free. So similarly, in the spiritual world, there is no talk and there is no walk. They only sing and they only dance. We are not at all. Sometimes in drunk situation, people imitate. But that is not real. Original, when you come to that, that only lasts for the night, and next day you have kidney problem, liver problem. That is artificial. But actually, we all like to dance and sing. That is natural. Because we are doing that in the spiritual world. So you purify your heart. Come permanently to that. You know, in America, when they're spreading the movement in the beginning, most of the people coming for drug addicts. So the message that other devotees who were previously drug addicts and became devotees, I told them, stay high forever. They made a leaflet with a distributing to the hippies. So you are taking drugs to stay high, correct? They take drugs, even in the colleges now, so common. In my, I think 20% students take every week. Sometime, at least once in a while, they get an idea what it is. So experiment. So a point is that you get high by drinking or smoking or drugs. But if you chant Hare Krishna, you get permanent high. Which is better? Without any side effect, without any overdose. Drugs you take overdose, you die. Liquor you take overdose, you can die. There's a BAL, I know there is some percentage. If this goes above a certain percentage, you die. But Krishna consciousness, there is no overdose, there is no side effect. So how nice it is. But, and there is no expenditure. It is free. But you don't want it. So here Krishna is saying, prakite kriyamanani gunes karmanani shabda. Whatever activities you do actually are pushed back today by your polluted consciousness. Okay? And polluted consciousness getting forced from the three gunas. Depending on the pollution, little less pollution, then sataguna will force you. More pollution, rajaguna. Too much pollution, the tamoguna will push you. All three are forces which are pushing our behavior. Like I gave the example of cold infection. I lose my original behavior. You can't say I'm sneezing by my own desire. No. An infection is forcing you to sneeze. Ahankara vimudhapa. I see I sneeze. Infection made you sneeze. Kartaham iti mandate. So similarly, you know, anytime, sometime we advertise ourselves, I did that, I did that, I did that. To this day, we have not done one activity out of our own free choice. All activities are pushed by Maya. Therefore, Prabhupada says, is it graceful to be embarrassed in this way? Will moment to moment push to do activities by the harassment of the senses. Prabhupada says, don't you think, why I should be pushed moment to moment to do activity by the harassment of the senses? Animal has no other option. In human form, flying option is there. Why don't we come out of that? No? One who is in this knowledge of the absolute of the mighty arm does not engage in the senses in the sense active gratification, knowing that the difference between working devotion and work of fruitive desire. So these two things we should clearly separate out. Prabhupada is saying the beautiful part. We know our awkward position here in this world. Okay? But still we should know that I am part and parcel of Krishna. I should be engaged in Krishna's service. And what should I do? How many shlokas are remaining?
Yeah.
43.
15.
Should I have finished now? Okay, bewildered by the modes of mental nature, if the ignorant fully engage themselves in mental activity and become attached, but the wise should not unsettle them. Knowing this duty, the inferior duty, the performance lack of knowledge. Just like Devi Puja, somebody is going, don't stop it. Buddha Puja, somebody is going, don't stop it. Let him do. That is his platform. But don't think that is the same platform as Krishna consciousness. Like some people have created, Yathoma Tathopa. That is not correct. You buy ticket to Bombay, you don't go to Madras. Therefore, Arjuna, this is, Prabhupada says, this is the purpose of Bhagavad Gita, this shloka. It's a very important shloka. You see the purport? This verse indicates the purpose of the Bhagavad Gita. What is this verse? Therefore, O Arjuna, surrendering all your works upon me, with my intent upon me, without desire for gain and free from egoism and lethargy, fight. So, for me, I want this war, fight. That's all. Surrendering all your works with my intent upon me. Again, me. You can't avoid Krishna. And without desire for gain and free from egoism and lethargy, fight. One who executes duties according to my injunctions and who follows this teaching faithfully without envy become free from bondage to fruitive activity. So when you act for Krishna, you become liberated. Okay? But those who out of envy disregard this teaching because, oh, who is this Krishna? Why have to serve him? Very good. Do not practice them regularly, are to be considered bereft of all knowledge, befooled and doomed to ignorance and bondage. Just like Krishna says, you don't follow me, you will be lost. Okay, sometimes parents tell them, you will be lost. So Krishna also is telling Supreme Father, but it is a fact. You don't listen to him, Krishna says, you will be lost. Even a man of knowledge acts according to his own nature, for everyone follows in nature. What can repression? Accomplish. This we have covered. Attraction and repulsion of sense objects are felt by embodied being. One should not fall under the control of the senses and sense objects because they are stumbling blocks on the path of self-realization. Mind is a tendency to get attached and repulse. It says be careful, keep your mind balanced. Otherwise, if you get attracted to sense objects and you start acting sensually, spiritual life will be finished. Okay? You cannot go to spiritual life when you are attracted to sense objects. It's not possible. You can't walk on two boats together. It is far better to discharge one's own prescribed duty even though they may be faulty than others' duty. Because Arjuna wanted duty of a sannyasi. So it again clarifies. Better work as a kshatriya, don't do others' duty, the sannyasi. Destruction in the course of performing one's duty is better than engaging another duty. For to follow another path is dangerous. One's man food is other man's poison. Now Arjuna asks a question. He's listening very intently. Like last chapter he asks a question. What is the behavior of a Sitapagana? Now here also he asks a question. Very important question. And all of us are in the platform. Oh descendant of Rishni. By what one is impelled to sinful acts even unwillingly as if engaged by force. We don't want to do, but we are forced to do sinful activity. Why Krishna this happens? Again now Krishna answers. Shri Bhagavan Vacha,
Shri Bhagavan Vacha,
Rama Esha Krodhesha,
Rama Esha Krodhesha,
Yoguna Samudbhavaha,
Yoguna Samudbhavaha,
Mahashano Mahapapma,
Mahashano Mahapapma,
Vidiyema Yivairina,
Vidiyema Yivairina.
The Blessed Lord said, it is lust only Arjuna which is born of the contact of the material mode of passion that transformed to wrath. The all devouring sinful enemy of this world. Kama, lust, Krodha, anger. How they are coming? The born from Rajaguna, our passion to enjoy this world, bring these two things. Mahashano, this is so bad, all devouring. Maha, not papa, mahapapa. Not ordinary papa, mahapapa. Vidhiyamiya verina. Now, many times what happens? We feel, no, I will figure it out. Like Krishna is telling, you can never figure out. Like many people say, I will drink and figure out if it is good or bad for me. Let me experiment. Correct? You can never figure out. You have to take Krishna's statement. Vidhi evam yavarina. Vidhi means to know. From whom? From me. This is your vairi. This is your enemy. That's all. Therefore, a devotee, moment a lust desire comes in his head, Krishna, Krishna, please save me. You should beg Krishna. Because he knows this is my enemy. Not that he gets delighted. Krodha comes in the system. Krishna, please save me. Why am I unnecessarily getting angry? So, therefore, you should pray to Krishna to save us from the activity. Why Krishna is saying it is? Mahapapa. not ordinary papa, mahapapa. How you know this? Krishna is telling. You don't figure out. Krishna is telling, accept it, that's all. The final judgment. As a fire is covered by smoke, a mirror is covered by dust, or an embryo is covered, and the womb still living in it is covered by different degrees of lust. The fire is covered by smoke, we know that. That is one level. That is human life. Okay? You can see the fire. So therefore, if you have a fan, full fire will come out. So any human being it may be, he has some Krishna consciousness. Therefore, your fan, his full Krishna consciousness will come out. Correct? Smoke is there, that means fire has started. You take a fan, bonk. So any man, if he takes, you encourage him to take a Krishna consciousness, he will become Krishna. You cannot do with dogs. Dog condition is next. That is mirror covered in the dust. Tiger, dog are all in that condition. You know, thick dust is there, not ordinary. You can't see your face also. Sometimes bathroom, if you use geyser and then come out, you can't see your face only, like that. So no use, nothing will happen. Are there embryos covered on the moon? That is plant life. Still thicker covering of the living. Originally living entity is blissfully dancing with Krishna. But you see here the covering of material energy, illusion. Embryo covered in the womb with the condition of the plant, thickest covering possible. Okay, so Prabhupada gives us the opportunity to tell this, fire covered by the smoke is human life. We can save any human being because he does have some Krishna consciousness. You know, whatever he may be called as the biggest atheist. You know, there was an aircraft disaster in Bangalore. Similarly, there was one more disaster in one place. And there, they did, you know, here also some people survived, that was a big plane. Some 150 survived, 150 died. So there was the interview done. What was all 300 people doing when the pilot announced some danger is there? Everybody was praying, even though many were atheists there. God, if you are there. So that is natural actually. So little Krishna consciousness everybody has. In a problem, everybody prays. He may call himself atheist also. I start praying at problem. That is natural. The sensitive mind and intelligence are sitting places of this lust which weaves the real knowledge of living entity and bewilders. So what happened? First attack happens with the senses. I'm very peaceful. I've gone to do some work. But senses get agitated now. I see, I'm a smoker, I see a cigarette. I want to smoke. Now senses are getting agitated. Still mind is saying, I don't want. But then mind, I want. Next. Intelligence is saying, no, we will not do it. It's not good for your health. Then intelligence starts planning where to hide a smoke. There are stages. Therefore, Arjuna, best of the path, in the very beginning, curbed this great symbol of sin lust by regulating the senses and slayed this destroyer of knowledge and self-realization. All spiritual self-realization knowledge is destroyed. Jnana vijnana nashanam by this thing. So, lust should be controlled. And Krishna gives more how to control. Indriyani parani aho.
Indriyani parani aho.
Indriyava paramamana.
Indriyava paramamana.
Manasasu paramunde.
Manasasu paramunde.
Indriyani parani ahu. Okay, please, it is said that more important than the body is the senses. This is a very important shloka. We can have 1 hour class on this. Because the reason is that if the senses are not there, the body is only lung. Okay? Indriyani paramana, more important the senses is the mind. Because without the mind, the senses are no meaning. Because senses are you know, like they say, bhans kya ki nahin bajana. Input comes, output should come, no reasonable output. So those people are rajoguna. See, tamoguna man is like, senses are also inactive. Rajoguna man, senses become active. Tamoguna man is sitting like this, sleeping. Say, so what is there? Tamoguna. Rajoguna, like so-called smart man on this world, he reacts immediately without thinking. That is the second platform, sensual platform. And higher than that is a mental platform. Indriyabhya paramamana, person thinks before activity. He is now a sattvic man. Very reasonable, sober man. Manasasu parabhute, above him is an intellectual man. Because he is philosopher. Yobuddhe parasasa, above him is the spiritual man. So more important the body is the senses. More important the senses is the mind. Because mind can control the senses. And mind can be controlled by the intelligence. And intelligence higher than the soul. So Krishna is saying, knowing this, you can control your senses. Engage the soul directly in Krishna's lotus feet. Automatically, all these followers will follow. So that is the word, direct form. The work is superior to dull matter, mind, intelligence. Mind is higher than the senses. Intelligence is still higher than the mind. And the soul is even higher than the intelligence. And last shloka, Krishna says, conclusion.
Thus knowing oneself to be transcendental to the material senses, mind and intelligence. Even though mind is saying something, intelligence is saying senses is saying something. No, I am higher than all these things. Knowing this, Krishna is saying, I am giving you the knowledge. You don't have it. Knowing oneself to be transcendental to material senses and mind, one should control the lower self by the higher self. And thus by spiritual strength, conquer this insatiable enemy known as Shri Prabhupada ki, Bhagavad Gita ki.